Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, KBN. Sponsored by Bud Light on ESPN Wisconsin, ESPN Madison on YouTube, and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Kyle, Brust, and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. I'm Ben Brust, alongside the whole crew. Kyle Wallace, the Packer backer, Bucks backer, Wisconsin backer. Brad Nortman, back from his NFL media combine training in L.A. He thinks he's a changed man, but I think after 3 hours of yesterday, we got him back to remembering he's just one of us.
It's all it took. All it took to remember I am indeed second place, Brad.
I didn't know we were back to counting the days you would wear free stuff again.
You know what? This is an issued gear. This is not free. I bought this t-shirt.
You bought a t-shirt?
No, hang on, time out.
You got 40?
Time out. He may have bought that t-shirt, but he's wearing pants that I got as issued gear in 2012.
Now, wait a minute. I know you didn't get these pants.
I got those pants. I have those pants.
These are bowl issued pants. These are Rose Bowl pants.
Well, they lied to you because you got the exact same ones.
Let me see. Stand up.
These are the days of pre-NIL, so they're just getting us whatever.
I mean, there ain't no Rose Bowl logo. They just lied to him and said, this is your Rose Bowl swag, a.k.a. what we have left over in the equipment room.
Where's the Rose Bowl? No, the 98th edition.
This is the 2010 season, 2011 Rose Bowl, and the pants didn't have anything on it. I do feel like it was just a normal Adidas zip-up, and they just slapped a rose on even the thing. The next year, the pants did have a rose on it, but yeah. Maybe Ben does. Maybe Ben was a secret, like, walk-on receiver or something like that that we didn't know. That's how he was able to sneak those pants.
No, I'm telling you, that was just issued gear where they stitch a logo on it to make it seem like it was Rose Bowl gear because I have those pants.
Those pants look pretty bait. They don't look like a big occasion. They just look like, hey, you guys.
How? How do you? Brad.
What?
I am not you. I didn't play in the NFL. I know I wear the same thing every single week. It's well documented. But take care of your damn self and Lexi deserves somebody who has new pants that aren't worn from 12 years ago.
But I like these pants. Why should I get rid of these pants?
Just because I can afford more pants.
That's some Kyle Wallace type stuff. I got clothes that old.
Do these pants look old? Do they show age? Does it look like they're from 2010? They're a little bit baggier than I'd like.
They're baggy.
That was the form back then.
Yeah, exactly. And maybe that style will come back in 10 years, but it's not here right now. Those pants, you could fit both your legs in one pant leg. They're so wide.
They're loose. They are loose pants. Each one, I mean, it's kind of like they're like bell bottoms, but the whole thing are bell bottoms.
Brad was so literal when he said last week was too much wearing dress clothes every single day.
Yes.
You were not joking about just wearing casual clothes all week.
This is what happens. You boomerang back hard to yourself, and I am back to being the Brad Nortman we all know and love.
I just can't believe you really do have on free issue.
What do you mean you can't believe it? Of course I can believe it.
Part of a bit. No. I know it's a lifestyle.
No, it's a lifestyle. It's Brad's lifestyle.
It feels great. I love the pants. They feel comfortable. It reminds me of the good old days. I got every reason to wear these pants. And actually, I feel bad for the current players that don't get to experience what it's like to go to a Rose Bowl and be given all the leftover pants that the basketball team gets to. That is character building that these college kids will never know because they're the NIL life.
800-990-3776. Again, 800-990-ESPN. We are also on YouTube at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee. And luckily for you, you can see Brad's upper half and you can't see those horrid pants that he's wearing from 14, 15 years ago. And on the ESPN Wisconsin Talking text line, Bucks bot account 2064 chimes in, Buck Nation, not sweating Pacers, even if Giannis part of series, they will still win in five. And I think that bot messed up because they meant to say, even if Giannis isn't part of the series, they will still win in five. And I do want to start with the Milwaukee Bucks. I do want to start with Giannis, and I want to start with the news of the unlikelihood of him being with the team early on in this series. We'll start from earlier today, where Stephen A. Smith, and very excited because if you missed it, Stephen A. Smith did join Thanasis for the Thanalysis show live at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. I'm sure you've seen teaser clips. He talks about Milwaukee in there, but he talks more specifically about the Milwaukee Bucks and their situation here.
If Milwaukee loses, I said, I think you need to consider moving Dame up out of there.
He just got there.
Let me explain. I'm not talking about his game. He's not happy there. Now, he's got a lot of distractions, which are his business, and we wish him nothing but the
best.
Nothing but the best. Because a lot of us would not be able to handle it as well as he's handling it. But nevertheless, whatever support system that you're looking for, and I'm sure they got love for him and they try to support him or whatever, but it's one of those situations where if you are not happy in a situation, albeit because of outside reasons.
Right. He wanted to go to Miami.
And I know he wanted to go to Miami, too. Let's call it what it is. I mean, you got all of that going on. That's a lot to deal with. I'm not talking about his game because I believe in Dame.
Yeah, for
sure. I'm talking about what he has to go through and psychologically how that situation may not be ideal for him.
That was Stephen A. Smith earlier today on Get Up with Greeny. And speaking of Greeny, he can't get enough of talking about Giannis and this Milwaukee Bucks because he had Brian Windhorst, Windy, joining and talking about what could happen if this team does lose in the first round. And I will pull up some Potawatomi odds so you guys know just how close the series price even is.
If they lose in the first round, that's a big statement right there, number one. If they lose in the first round, the first person you're worried about isn't Dame. It's Giannis. Mm. You want to make sure Giannis is still committed. And also, when you talk about this first round, you got to worry about where Giannis' calf is, if he's going to be 100%. But if they go down in the first round again, they have that disappointment back-to-back years, I'm not sure where Giannis is going to be. But no matter what happens, this is a flawed roster. They clearly did not, the panacea that they thought Dame Lillard was going to be wasn't the case. They're going to have to make changes one way or another, and they basically mortgaged their entire draft in the future. So they're going to have to get creative, and I do think it's possible that Dame could be looked at. But you got to make sure Giannis is committed to it first.
So a lot happening in the Milwaukee Bucks world, and this odds to win the series here from Pato Sportsbook. You'd have to bet the Bucks minus 136. Bet 136 to get 100 back. So they're favorites. But the Pacers only plus 110. And we're talking about a first-round series. Typically, this first-round series, especially for a world championship-caliber team, you're not even going to see it on the board because it is a lock for the ones and the two seeds to typically win these. Now, I know we're living in a world where the Bucks did lose last year as a first seed, but what I'd said is true through the history of the ones and two seeds of the NBA. Now, with that said, I do want to start with the 414 expert, our guy, Kyle Wallace, because, again, and it was 250 to open. With Giannis' injury, it was 185 this morning, and then the news came out. It's down to 136. That scares me from a first-round perspective, but your takeaway, because you are Mr. Milwaukee, and from a Giannis or Dame perspective, there's a lot here in terms of, like, keeping Giannis happy? Is Dame the right guy? Was the trade worth it?
I'm growing real weary of all this, right? We got rid of Aaron Rodgers, which meant I thought we got rid of drama within my sports team. But unfortunately, this whole season with the Milwaukee Bucks, from the very first moment the Bucks got rid of Terry Stotts early on in the season when Adrian Griffin removed him from the staff, or he left. This team has been filled with drama, and it's because of the expectations that they have, and I'm very nervous that the expectations are too much for the Bucks, and they are not ready for the moment. Whether it's Doc Rivers constantly saying something in the press, Giannis, you know, just getting hurt, but just overall, just Giannis just not seeming like this team was going in the right direction, Dame just not looking passionate about being around here. I'm just sick and tired of the drama, but overall, I just need some clarity because all these assumptions being made about whether Dame wants to be here or not, if Dame is not here, that is very unsettling for me because that means that this trade was a failure. This trade is a disaster, like an absolute disaster. The Bucks have to make a run in this playoffs in order for this to be successful. So I don't think the trade is a disaster yet or a failure.
And it's funny you say that because us three were, I want to say we were meeting before our show, and news broke that Damian Lillard was being traded to the Milwaukee Bucks. And at that point, it was this year, championship or bust.
Yeah.
Because of all we had heard off in the offseason about Giannis and wanting, like, changing his narrative a little bit from the end of the getting bounced at the end of the playoffs last year or the early in the playoffs last year as a one seed, you know, it's steps to success and all of that. For me, it's just like, if you're going to say that and then go to a New York Times article and talk about how your legacy is important for championships, it went from Dame was traded, we're all excited, championship or bust now, to hearing Kyle talk about, Well, now we need to make a run just to keep Giannis and Dame maybe together.
The thing about what I'm feeling, right, I run based off emotion and then also information, right?
But
Mostly emotion. I get information and I take it and I say, I feel the vibe, right? None of us feel the vibe that this team is about to make a championship run. We don't feel that energy. In 2021, we were hopeful, right? We felt good about that. When they lost to the Raptors as well, in 20, I think it was 19, we still had this feel, this vibe. We felt good. There just seems to be a lack of energy from the players on the court, which has now been on to us as fans. And I don't feel like anybody really truly believes the Milwaukee Bucks are going to win the championship this year.
Everything about this team has been off from the start of the year. That's the best way I can put it. Just nothing has felt right, whether it be team chemistry, what is going on at head coach, between, you know, Griffin getting fired, bringing in Doc Rivers, Doc having a hard time putting his arms around this team and being able to say, you're seeing weird things in the media and clearly not being the leader they thought he would be. Dame is clearly not engaged. Chris Middleton, Brooke Lopez look slow and old. Even Giannis, who has had some great games, he's putting up great stats, or something off about what this team is and where they're going. I mean, think about last year. We were shocked, appalled, and upset with the fact that the Milwaukee Bucks got bounced in the first round. If it were to happen this year, no one would be surprised. Think about that.
Expectations have gone down. We felt last year that team had a real chance to win a championship. That's why we were all shocked. This year, like you said, we had these high expectations, but that feel of expecting them to make a championship run, it just doesn't feel there. You're right. Something is missing. Something is off.
Something is off. And because of that, the trade was a bad trade now. Looking at it, it was not worth it.
No matter what.
I mean, it's impossible to say what is going to happen in the future. As I'm sitting here now, this team is worse than they were before. They're more off than they were before. They have less leadership, more drama. Everything about our expectations have been completely eroded. One of your superstars allegedly doesn't even want to be here. So there's nothing that I am looking at this that I can say this was a good trade. I have my least level of optimism since 2017 for the Milwaukee Bucks.
Yikes.
When they got bounced in the first round. The year after that is when they played Toronto and lost in the Eastern Conference Finals. Mm. Ever since that year, since the Bucks played Toronto in the Eastern Conference Finals, I thought any year the Bucks could win the NBA championship.
And it should be that with a top five player in the NBA.
And currently, I feel like the least amount of optimism I have for the Milwaukee Bucks. And that's saying something.
800-990-3776. And that is saying something. I do want to know, is this the least optimistic you've ever been during the Giannis era? Because, I mean, there's been some times where they're down 0-2 in different series. The Nets in the NBA Finals.
Yeah.
Last year losing in the first round. Is this a new low? Are you the least optimistic you've ever been? 800-990-3776. Leroy. What's up, Leroy?
What's up? What's up, Kyle, y'all? Brust, y'all, man. Man, I'm scared.
Yeah?
I'm scared. I'm scared, Brust and Kyle, y'all, because I ain't never seen some, and I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and I've been a Bucks fan for a long time. And, you know, we celebrated in 2021. But Kyle and Brush, I'm scared, man. I'm a Giannis fan.
Yeah, Brad
I'm
is scared,
I'm a Giannis
too.
Fan.
Well, Leroy, we love
because,
you. Why you leave out Brad like that?
Leroy,
too.
I'm here too, man. Say hi to Brad.
I know you are, Brad. I love you too.
Thanks,
man. I love the KBN Nation.
I love you, the KBN Nation.
I just want that represent that.
Yes.
Thank you, Leroy. But like that is an emotion you should feel based off of the sound we heard from Stephen A. Based off the sound we heard from Brian Windhorst. It's an eerie time to be a Milwaukee Bucks fan, and it's eerie that when you have a top player like Giannis. Everyone talks about how nobody talks about the small market. Well, guess what? They're talking about the small market on the morning show, on Get Up, on Greeny, on everywhere, and it's not for good reasons. 800-990-3776. We'll continue to hear from KBN Nation on the Milwaukee Bucks. Is this trade a win if they don't win? Is this trade a loss no matter what if they don't win a championship? Because to me, it feels like it is heading that way no matter what, because I have no belief. 800-990-ESPN. We'll hear from you, KBN Nation, next.
This is Kyle Brust and Nortman.
Milwaukee County, you need to shovel the pathway to the lake, okay? I had to step through snow.
Is Kyle
get to the lake?
I think Kyle's the Karen of the show.
I think he's high maintenance, for sure.
I think Kyle pays taxes in the county of Milwaukee that just went up, so I expect for this stuff to be popped.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about Zimbrick European. They're Mercedes, Audi, Porsche, and certified pre-owned. But the best part is, I've been working with them since 2018, and the evolution has been a two-door, a four-door, and now it's time for an SUV. My life has changed, and it's changed with Zimbrick European. Being a dad has made it really important to have the comfort and the safety that the SUV will bring me. Again, Zimbrick European, off the Beltline at Rimrock Road. Of course, I found the sexiest car on the lot. Check them out.
It's our lowest prices of the season at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Right now, shop unbeatable deals on the things you need for spring. Like 20-pound bags of BioAdvance 24-hour grub killer granules, $27.99 after sale and $10 mail-in rebate. Get our lowest price of the season on Fast Orange Hand Cleaner with Pumice, $10.49 a gallon. And save $2 on CRC Pro Series Brake Parts Cleaner, just $6.99. Don't miss our lowest prices of the season in-store or online at farmandfleet.com.
This PGA Tour moment is brought to you by True Green.
Greg Norman, Seve Ballesteros, and Augusta native Larry Mize began a sudden-death playoff at the 1987 Masters. After Ballesteros was eliminated, missing a 5-foot putt for par on number 10, Mize and Norman moved on to 11. Mize sank a 140-foot chip for an improbable birdie. Norman failed to hole his, and Mize captured his first and only major with one of the most miraculous shots in major championship history.
True Green, the official lawn care treatment provider of the PGA Tour.
I love a beautiful lawn. I hate doing lawn care. That's why I use True Green. They're the official lawn treatment provider of the PGA Tour. We all know those are some nice greens. So just imagine what they could do to your lawn. All you have to do is water and mow. And to top it off, when you sign up for an annual plan by April 20th, get one application free. Visit TrueGreen.com for the best lawn at the best price, guaranteed. Restrictions apply.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
As you're putting your spring calendar together, we'd love to have you join us Saturday, May 18th for Mark Osiki's 6th Annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament to support the American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. We're on the Madison Chain of Lakes early, then back at the Alliant Energy Center for 2:30 happy hour, dinner, and live and silent auctions with cool autographed hockey items, guided tours, and a brand new fishing boat. There's even more on our website, castingforkids.org. Help us help the kids. castingforkids.org.
This is Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, sponsored by Bud Light on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
Feels like forever tonight.
If Milwaukee loses, I said, I think you need to consider moving Dame up out of there.
That was Stephen A. Smith on Get Up, and it's not a crazy thought because, again, In Giannis's window to win a championship, you need everyone bought in. And you know what we just discussed? How this season from start to finish has felt so disconnected. So disconnected. From starting with Adrian Griffin, to Joe Prunty, as you mentioned, being associate head coach, gone, to hiring hiring Doc Rivers in the middle of the season, who was consulting Adrian Griffin, to them having a losing record with Doc as the head coach in the regular season, and now with Giannis hurt heading into the playoffs, this season could not have gone any worse leading up to right now. Now, what I will say is if you do have faith that in the playoffs, for the same reason that you traded for Dame, that this team can beat the Pacers, it's your best time to get the best odds right now for the Bucks to win the series. They're only minus 135. This series opened at minus 250 for the Bucks to win. So you are a financial analyst, like maybe a Brad Nortman was in his previous life. There is value now to buy the Bucks winning this series better than it was to start. And your belief would be that Dame, who has not played great without Giannis, might be able to elevate this team to what should be beating the Indiana Pacers.
Yeah, I mean, with every high possible reward investment, there is a high level of risk. And that's all I'm seeing with this team. It's not like this team even struggled and caught a little bit of identity and a little bit of fire going into the playoffs.
Who are they?
The exact opposite happened. They are losing to bad teams exactly when they should be playing their best basketball. And you talked about everybody being locked in, everyone having a sole focus on winning an NBA championship. I feel like this team had that in prior years, for sure 2021 when they actually won it. But I'm wondering, like, Dame seems distracted. Doc sort of took this job on a flyer, and he has not held himself together that a head coach should possibly do.
He wasn't super excited in his presser.
In the introductory.
I don't know why they fired him.
And so Chris Middleton looks very old and very unhealthy physically. I don't want to put him out there, but he is. He's not healthy physically. Brook Lopez looks slow. Even the guys off the bench outside of Bobby Portis have taken a big step back. So for every level of it, and even Giannis plays hard on the court, but this is Kyle Wallace, which you get after Giannis about all the time, and Homer. When he talks about Giannis isn't that leader, Giannis brings it himself every single time, but clearly the guys around him aren't playing at his level or level of focus either.
800-990-3776, Kyle, Brust, and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin, full crew here today. Look, I want to hear from KBN Nation. Brian in St. Francis, where are you right now? Where are you? Are you as pessimistic as Brad is about where the Bucks are?
Well, you guys, thanks for taking my call. Someone brought up that superstar is unhappy. Would that be Dame?
Yes, it is. It is Dame. Dame has had personal issues, let's be honest, he did not want to be Miami was his first choice. He didn't go to Miami, which is interesting because his personal issues being even further away would have been interesting. But ultimately,
Miami got a lot of people who can take your mind off.
But personally, yes, I think Dame overall is not happy.
Because I did see a story when I Googled this morning that they had a picture of Dame that he was unhappy. And then I thought maybe it's just a false story. But I did read a story not too long ago that he's bored. He's bored here. His family is back in Portland. And I'm thinking, okay, maybe there is some truth. And now you guys said it. And the thing of it is, he doesn't show very much. He's expressionless. It's always the straight. It's always the same look. You don't know what he's thinking. And not too long ago, I was going to call in and ask you guys, was it a good trade that I question the trade now?
Yeah, it's a great question, Brian.
I'm getting him.
Yeah, an 800-990-3776. I mean, to this point, unless they win a championship, the trade wasn't worth it. Even if you get to the Eastern Conference Finals, which feels like a pipe dream
That feels like a long way away, doesn't it?
Here's the thing. I'm not going to go as far as saying the trade wasn't worth it because the last alliteration of this team is the fact that we knew it was over. Like, the reason why they got rid of Drew, they were just trying to fix something by firing a coach and hiring a new coach, and we found out Adrian Griffin wasn't the one.
What does it say about Horst that Drew Holiday not only signed for 4 years and however many million dollars with the Celtics,
he won't be with the Celtics through that contract.
Hear me out for a second. Not only is Drew Holiday important to the Boston Celtics and what they believe he can be for their success as they're trying to make their run at championships in the East, he is one of 11 players that have been mentioned of 12 to be on the USA Olympic team. And why that is important is because if you remember back when they did win the NBA championship, mm-hmm. Chris Middleton and Drew Holiday got on a flight a week after they won the NBA championship, and Greg Popovich, the head coach, talked about who was the most important piece to helping them win. And that was Drew Holiday because of what he brings defensively.
But the Bucks weren't in a position. Here's the issue. Who are the number one and number two players on the Boston Celtics?
Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum.
Who were the one and two players on the Milwaukee Bucks
last season? Giannis and Chris.
No, stop it. Stop it.
Well, you're paying Chris to be that.
Chris was the championship run.
Chris has been injured. That's the whole point. Chris has been hurt. He is not the same guy. He is not the real number two on the team. It's Drew Holiday as the number two. Drew Holiday being a number two at this point in his career for a team that has championship aspirations is not going to be successful. Now, he can play a role where he can be a defender, knock down an open shot, facilitate a little bit, but he is just another guy that can play defense and be another offensive weapon, but he is not the focal point of the offense. In Milwaukee, we needed him to step up for us offensively if Giannis was out, if Chris was out. He was the guy that we needed to step up. He became number two, and at this point in his career, Drew Holiday is not a number two on a championship team.
Well, that's true. He's not a number two on a championship team. And it just goes to reflect that this trade was one of many errors that the Bucks have made along the way. Hiring Coach Griffin was a bad hire now in retrospect. Giving Lopez and Chris Middleton those big contracts when they're old and injury prone. Bad. They're old. They're bad decisions. It's been a lot of bad decisions. You got to give them a lot of credit leading up to the championship. But since the championship was won, this team got a little bit of egotistical. They think they can just do whatever they want to do, keep running it back. They didn't stay fresh. They didn't stay green. And now you're paying for it.
Yeah, and I think a lot of great comments on YouTube right now. Like, I think that loyalty is actually going to end up biting the Bucks right now.
100%.
So we trade Dame for Drew, LOL. Honestly, what do we even get back from him? Who will take on his contract? That's a part of it. Who's going to want to take on a Middleton or a Lopez? Well, who's going to want to take on? I mean, trade deadline came. Nobody was buying in these Bucks players. And then when you think about keeping Giannis happy, how about the fact that, like, why would Giannis want to stay, right? Like, you have
He made this mess, so he's going to have to lay in it.
But that's not how it works.
He's going to have to lay in it.
I'm not saying.
I would make him sit on the bench unhappy.
That's not how it works.
James Harden. Absolutely not. You're the reason why. And again,
you're going to do that to the guy who brought you a championship for the first time in 50 years?
It. Listen, when people get married, they're all in love. And next thing you know, they throwing, you know, cutting up their clothes and scratching their car. I don't know about that. Never happened to me. Maybe it did. But here's the thing.
Sounds like it did.
Never married.
You had your own Elon?
Elon. So what I'm saying is that, yes, we love us some Giannis, but at the end of the day, the reason why Chris is still here, the reason why Robin is here, the reason why Dame is here is because we are trying to put a team around Giannis. And specifically when it comes to Brooke and it comes to Chris, they are here because they're Alan Lazard and Randall Cobb. Because if Aaron Rodgers was going to go to the Jets, he was going to have his boys come with him, and Giannis was not going to let his boys christen Brooke Lopez leave this team.
800-990-3776. Zach chimes in. He's already tossing a Benjamin on it. Keep fearing the deer, ? He's buying while it's low. And Ryan says, let's wait to jump off a cliff until we see a first few games or a series or two.
As Ryan, what is your level of confidence going into these playoffs?
You can ask
the Milwaukee Bucks. Ryan, I want you Ryan, what is your level? I was going to say type to him, but what is your level of confidence going into this playoffs thinking that the Milwaukee Bucks are going to win a championship? Are you optimistic? If your level of confidence is lower than an 8, then you're just like us.
Yeah, because it needs to be a 9 or a 10 with where Giannis is at and what these what the organization needs to do to keep him happy. Quickly to Diana and Maguana go.
Hey.
Hopefully you have more than a couple words for me, Diana. How you feeling?
Keep it dirty.
Yes, I do. Hey, first of all, was Dame wasn't forced to come here, so if he's so unhappy, then why is he here?
I mean,
he was kind of forced.
Yes.
They traded for him, and he didn't really have much of a say.
He's very inconsistent.
You're not wrong.
I'm very, very worried, but I am hopeful at the same time.
So I like that you're
that we can get
through. Yeah, it makes sense.
Very accurate.
But that's the problem. being inconsistent and hopeful is not a strategy that Bucks fans should be feeling with the top three player and the two-time MVP that Giannis Antetokounmpo is in his prime of trying to win championships. Being hopeful heading into a first round of a series while he's hurt, that's showing the roster is not good enough to hold down the fort while he's gone. The Pato series price shows that as well. You know, he's a sneaky NBA guy, and he's really good at talking about it. That's a Packers Hall of Famer, Mark Tauscher, joining us next. But first, real quick, Brad, tell us about Gina Della from Pella.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Gina Della from Pella. We're never concerned about Pella getting bounced in the opening round. They are championship caliber every single year. That's because with Pella new windows and doors, your home can have a luxurious look, a sleek, beautiful design, custom colors to fit your space, and give your home that extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. It totally transformed the space. You should see some of the products that they do. It is unbelievable what it can do to the inside, the outside of your home. Increases your home value, decreases your energy costs. It's absolutely the best of both worlds. And now getting the perfect windows and doors from Pella has never been easier. Right now you can get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. It is a pick your deal. Whatever works best for you, Pella wants to give you that opportunity to have the luxurious, beautiful, quality, and durable Pella windows and doors for your home. Take ownership of your living space, make it a place worth living, with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Mark Tauscher joins us next.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
If I was as tall and as talented as you, if I could shoot as well as you could, both them teams would have won. Because you know what?
Okay.
You did a fake punch, you said, in the Rose Bowl?
Yeah.
And I would have did a fake point. I would have took it to the house. I would have scored a dang touchdown.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Ben Brust here from Kyle, Brust, and Nortman and tell you about the newest spike tea on the market, and that is Hoop Tea. And when I mean that it's the newest and best, it was born on the boardwalk of Ocean City, Maryland, and enjoyed now right here in Madison, Wisconsin. With flavors like an original spike tea, you have peach, you have mango, you have watermelon. Hoop Tea will make you feeling great with whatever flavor fits your profile. Hoop Tea. Enjoy the hoops on the screen and hoops in your hand. HoopTea.com. Must be 21 years or older to enjoy.
Suit up for the $800,000 Sports Car Series at Potawatomi Casino Hotel Milwaukee. April through May, score free play, cash, one of four new Toyota GR86s, or a new Toyota Supra. Play with your club card to earn entries, five times the entries on drawing days, and when the Milwaukee Brewers play at home. Got what it takes, slugger? Only at Potawatomi. For more details, visit facebig.com/sportscar. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
When you're in the right place at the right time, things get done. The important things, like knowing what you need and how it all works. Talking truck. Fixing it right the first time. At Zimbrick Chevrolet, our people get it done right and now. That's how you know you're in the right place at the right time. And you'll never overpay at Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Life has its moments, times to remember and share. Make the most of those special occasions by visiting Goodman's Jewelers at 220 State Street. John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. We're here to help you make that perfect selection for your memorable moment. When you think of diamonds, you hear about color, cut, clarity, and carat weight. We can help you understand that. But we're equally concerned with earning your trust with the quality of our selection and our service. Goodman'sJewelers.com, in the heart of downtown Madison. Truly a destination worth reaching.
In the next 30 seconds, I'm going to tell you how to save money and save the planet. It's simple. Ditch your energy bill and make the switch over to Everlight Solar. While electricity prices keep rising, Everlight Solar will give you the chance to take ownership of your power while also reducing your carbon footprint. As a local company based out of Madison, they'll be there with you every step of the way as you make the switch to solar. To learn more about how you can save money and save the planet, go to EverlightSolar.com.
If you want a fresh twist on surf and turf, look no further than North and South Seafood and Smokehouse. Inspired by their time living in the Alaskan Gulf in southern Texas, owners Keith and Aaron brought together unique culinary backgrounds to create a truly authentic American restaurant here in Madison. After expanding to two more locations in DeForest and Verona, you can savor smoky wood-fired barbecue and freshly prepared seafood from around the country. Explore their full menu and dining options at eatnorthandsouth.com. That's eatnorthandsouth.com.
I've been here for 28 years. I didn't know anything about trailers when I started here, and now I know a lot about trailers. I enjoy what I do very much. I like the interaction that I have with my coworkers and the pride that you have making the trailers. You always see them going down the road and you say, hey, that blue and white sticker, I made that trailer. My name is Sue and I'm proud to be a part of Stoughton Trailers.
Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
It's ESPN Wisconsin's Ben Brust for Road America, America's National Park of Speed. Make the most out of your summer at Road America, located conveniently between Green Bay, Milwaukee, and Madison in Elkhart Lake. Come see a race at the legendary 4-mile, 14-turn road course, camp on site all weekend, and enjoy free admission for kids 16 and under with a paying adult at the gate. Make sure you get tickets for the NTT IndyCar Series race at Road America June 6th through the 9th. Come for the experience and stay for the race. Get your tickets at roadamerica.com.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you. Only you can let it in. No one else. No
joining
one
us
else
now on Kyle, Brust, and Nortman is the Packers Hall of Famer, Mark Tauscher of Wildy and Tausch, which you can hear 9 to noon across these very stations. We are Kyle, Brust, and Nortman. Welcome in, OT.
Hello, fellas. How are y'all?
We're doing good. You know, I mean,
don't say that. We're all.
I mean, we're healthy.
We're
but the Bucks aren't.
Yeah. No, we don't feel good, man.
Good perspective.
You got from Get Up to Greeny to Wildy and Tausch with Evan Cohen. Everyone's talking about Giannis and Dame. And old T, I consider you an NBA novice, at least when it comes to our local team here in the Milwaukee Bucks. Could this have gone any worse this season?
Do you know what? Do you know what the term novice means?
Yeah.
No.
It means like beginner.
You're saying I don't know anything about the NBA.
What's a better word than for expert?
Savant.
NBA Milwaukee Bucks savant Mark Tauscher joins us.
Okay. Yeah, he's making a mockery of you.
So I'm not as
Old T knows that I respect his NBA.
And you should, because I do pay attention. And I think to answer your question, I was on the Dalla Dame trade. I was leading the charge, because you watched last year when Giannis was hurt, the way the Miami Heat just, you know, beat us into submission. And you knew, for as much as we loved Drew Holiday and his defensive approach, he had no answers for Jimmy Butler. He's not a scorer. And Giannis, the hot potato, and I know you remember this, at the end of that game,
ridiculous.
It made me sick.
Mm-hmm.
So I think as a Bucks fan, you knew something had to change. So talking to Evan Cohen from Unsportsmanlike this morning, mad that they made the trade. It obviously has not panned out like we hoped, because you're sitting here and struggling. And now, can they flip the switch here and all of a sudden be Eastern Conference Finals playing Boston? Yeah, they could. I don't think any of us on this panel think that's what's going to happen. So I don't mind. You have to take big swings when you have somebody like Giannis. What we were doing wasn't working, so you went big. It's not worked. Doesn't mean you can't move some pieces around. As long as Giannis, the thing that freaked me out this morning wasn't Stephen A. Smith saying, Dalla Dame might want to get traded. He's unhappy. And we all see he's not real happy. The thing that freaked me out is when Wendy, who is dialed in, said, you guys aren't asking the right question. Giannis is going to want to stick around. That's the part that because that's the case. We're in big trouble. So hopefully everything will settle in. Giannis will be able to come back middle of this series. The Bucks will advance. They'll get to the Eastern Conference Finals, and then we have a great series with Boston. Let's see how it plays out. Then I think everybody can settle in. But if this series goes poorly, we don't advance, there'll be a lot of changes, and I don't know to what degree, and that should scare all Bucks fans.
Old T, can you do me a favor? I've never heard this in my life doing radio. Your phone is going, like, really high, and then you disappear, and then you come back. So you could just call us right back, because I do want to comment on the Wendy thing. There he is. Good. He's a good listener. Mark Tauscher, 800-990-3776. Chris, I don't know if you're going to call him back or not. And it's true, right? Like, we talked about it in the first segment of the show. If you missed any of our show, go to WisconsinOnDemand.com. Wendy talked about how, like, it's about keeping Giannis happy more than who cares about Dame's feelings. I think they're hand in hand.
Listen, they literally got him a top 75 player of all time. They re-signed Chris Middleton to a contract that Chris Middleton, honestly, is not healthy enough to deserve this contract. They re-signed Brook Lopez because they didn't have an alternative, and they knew that he liked Brook. What else do you want them to do? And I love Thanasis, but Thanasis is on this team constantly, and he's a talented player. But I'm sure the relationship that he has with his brother helps him have a roster spot on this team. And so what I'm saying is, like, what more can we do to make him happy?
And we welcome back in the Packers Hall of Famer, Mark Tauscher. And so you talked about Wendy, and it might not be about.
Quick question before you do that. So I went AirPods. Thinking it bit a better connection. AirPods not better than just regular phone?
You know, you sound just as good audio-wise, but you were fading in, and then it got completely silent, and then you'd fade back up like someone had a slider.
Because I went AirPods strictly to try to sound even better for you guys, so that's frustrating.
We know you care, old T, but I want to ask you this. Because of the fear of Giannis being a part of back-to-back first-round potential exits, don't you think it might be better if he doesn't play at all? Because if he plays and they somehow lose this first round, he will feel so embarrassed of being part of back-to-back first-round exits that the franchise should protect themselves in doing whatever they can to not let him play, because they could potentially lose him for all these reasons we're talking about.
That's a loser's mentality. No, if he's healthy,
you can't risk Giannis.
No, listen, if he is not healthy, you don't play him. But you're not going to not play him because you're afraid of his psyche, that he might be sad that they lose in the first round again?
It's not psyche.
No,
that would just be him saying, all right, that's two straight first-round exit. I'm out of here. He's not a part of that if he doesn't play. You got your injury reason. Keep him out of that, because the Deer District's a big investment, and that doesn't fill up as big without 34.
No, you need 34 here. And, the question I have is, all these decisions are run by Giannis. It's not like they're trading for Dalla Dame without asking his input. So at some point, you have to wonder, is Giannis a good GM? I mean, that's a question you can ask.
No player in Wisconsin sports history has been a good general manager. All they do is ruin our franchises.
Well, I have a hard time sitting here arguing that, if he was part of getting Drew Holiday, that was a great pickup. So that part was great. You don't want players doing it. You want your guys to feel engaged. You want input from them. But in the grand scheme of things, no, it does look like you don't necessarily want players dabbling too much, because there's too much interpersonal stuff that comes into play, and you're maybe not looking at things in the right mindset that you need to in order to form a good team.
Well, Tausch, that leads me to my next question is, we can all agree that this regular season was a failure, and going to the playoffs, we can hope they turn things around, but it has been a disaster up to this point. I got to ask, who is primarily to blame in your eyes? Because Kyle thinks it's Giannis with lack of leadership and for making those GM-like decisions. I say it's John Horst, because he let Giannis have too much power, and all these bad deals led the team to success. So who is most primarily to blame for this season?
I think when you look at it, you have to put some at the footstep of John Horst, but this is a player's deal, and I just don't think Damian Lillard has played up to the level. I think you could put some on Brook Lopez, Pat Connaughton. I mean, you can start looking at the list of players.
Oof.
And you could say, well, coaching, everything else. But the reason this team has struggled, and, with all that said, were we talking like this when they were the 3 seed and they won the NBA championship?
Yeah, that's not apples to apples, though, Tausch. You know that.
No, I know it's not, but I'm saying, when we're saying, what a horrible regular season.
No.
All I'm saying is, we're literally in the same spot. Now, I felt a lot better then, but you get what I'm saying. So when you factor all that stuff in, yeah, you can be frustrated. You can look at it from that way, but the players have gotten older, and there's just not enough athleticism. That's what jumps out to me when I watch this team.
Yeah, no, I hear you. The difference being is without Giannis in the first couple games of the Indiana series in the first round against the Pacers, the series price is their minus 135 favorites. And without Giannis, Drew Holiday and Chris Middleton were able to will them in an Eastern Conference Finals. So that's how different we are in, even though they're both three seeds. Kyle, go ahead.
Yeah, we were talking about the Atlanta Hawks back then, so we had more confidence. But Tosh, what it comes down to is this, is that when we were a three seed, we saw the Nets, right? We saw good basketball teams, and we were like, all right, let's see what this team can do. We had the expectation that this team would be in it at the end when they're talking about the NBA Finals, and you don't have the confidence that this team is going to be in it. You said it yourself. We don't believe they're going to flip a switch.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just – it's a you watch enough games and you kind of see – and again, I don't have the same issues that, you know, the Bucks took these big shots trying to get Dame, you know, getting Dame and all this, but it just hasn't worked. And I think the only way it's going to work is if Damian Lillard becomes that superstar, consistent player that we need in order to see this team take that next step and flip the switch. And then Chris Middleton has to be healthy, and he has not been. So you want to look back at it, it's, you continued to run back this team that wasn't good enough last year. And when you do that, they're not going to get younger. So you just kind of hope that you be as healthy as possible when you get to this postseason. And unfortunately, Giannis gets hurt and you're not healthy. And now you're sitting here with your best player not being able to play to start this series. And you're in a real dogfight to even advance one round.
Talking old team, Packers Hall of Famer Mark Tauscher here on Kyle, Brust, and Nortman. Switching gears here, how refreshing is it to have Jair Alexander and, like, the non-nonsense around the Green Bay Packers heading into a big year for them?
Yeah, I was excited to see that he was there because I think, you know, new coordinator, I think he's going to be excited about. But the way the season played last year and kind of how that shook out, I was wondering – where's Jair's? And there's still going to be some issues, I'm sure, that come up. But the fact that he was there for the opening day of this with everything involved tells me he understands he needs to have a good year. And All of the shenanigans that we saw last year, hopefully that's all a thing in the past and that he can focus and get back to being one of those top shutdown corners that this defense is going to need in order for this team to take the next step.
You don't think it's the fact that the guy he couldn't stand and didn't believe in, I should say, not stand, but the guy he didn't believe in and trust is gone, and Joe Barry?
Did you listen? He said he's excited for Halfley to be there. That's basically saying in backwards way.
I think that's a big part of it. I think that was a big part of it, but again, I think you can get caught up in all that. I think there was a lot of issues that have been going on, and now that you have a fresh start with a new coordinator, with new eyes, you have to kind of prove yourself all over again. Now everybody has high expectations for Jair. He has not played good football consistently the last two seasons. He's going to need to in order for this defense to be executed the way that Halfley wants it to be.
Old T, thanks for getting the phone situated for us. We really look forward to talking to you, hopefully after a good start to the Bucks series.
Of the three of you, anyone got the Bucks not advancing past the Pacers?
Not me. You know,
I think they're going to advance.
I think it's a buy opportunity, Tausch. This series opened minus 250. I think at minus 135, I might have to go take my money where my mouth is and put a little at Pato Sportsbook.
There you go, boys. All right, see you, fellas.
That's Old T. Here I'm on Wildy and Tausch. And Kyle, tell the fans how they can get involved with stories behind the Bucks.
Oh, tune in to Behind the Bucks on the Bucks Plus Audio Network, presented by Gallagher, your trusted insurance broker and HR benefits consultant. Behind the Bucks dives deep into Bucks and Six, a culture unknowingly created by former Bucks star Brandon Jennings. Take a look inside the Brandon Jennings story, the origin of Bucks and Six, how it became the rallying cry, and what it truly means to be Jennings and Bucks fans alike. Find Behind the Bucks on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, and wherever you get your podcast. Behind the Bucks is presented by Gallagher.
800-990-3776. I hear from KBN Nation on the talk and text line on YouTube. We'll get to you next.
This is Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, KBN.
You throw hands?
Do I throw hands?
With T.O.
Will I? No, I throw hands with Andre the Giant, man.
I love you, Will. That's Lewis from the North Side. The North Side always knows.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
U-rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
Varsity on Wisconsin On Demand is home to all the latest and best Badgers content on ESPN Wisconsin. Subscribe on Apple, Spotify, Wisconsin On Demand, and wherever you get your podcasts. Wisconsin men's hockey senior goaltender Kyle McClellan has been named the winner of the 2024 Mike Richter Award, which is given to the nation's top Division I men's goaltender. McClellan went 24-12-1 on the season, posting 7 shutouts and a .931 save percentage. In its 11th year, this is the first time a Wisconsin goaltender has been awarded the Mike Richter Award, who played for Wisconsin from 1985 to 1987 and won a Stanley Cup with the New York Rangers in 1994.
Get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months. Book before April 30th at PellaWI.com.
You're back at the gym. Your new gym outfit? On point. Your new sneakers? Baller. You've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking. It's maintenance fee free with no minimum balance requirements. So when you take your first yoga class in 10 months, your body might surprise you, but your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Hey, are you having a hard time dealing with high-interest credit card debt? It's normal, and a SoFi personal loan could help you save thousands by consolidating your DEVT to one low fixed monthly payment. You could get $5,000 to $100,000 as soon as the same day you sign, with no fees required. It only takes 60 seconds to view your rate, and it won't affect your credit score. View your rate at SoFi.com/paid off. Loans originated by SoFi Bank N.A. Member FDIC. Terms and conditions at SoFi.com/paid off. NMLS 696891.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Get ready to crush your fitness goals at Prairie Athletic Club, the ultimate destination for health, wellness, and recreation. This is Sarah Tauscher. The pack has everything you need to succeed, from group fitness classes to personal training, indoor and outdoor pools, soccer fields, and so much more. Your fitness goals start at the pack. Don't miss out. Their summer memberships are now available. So join before those rates go up. Stop by or visit PrairieAthletic.com today. That's PrairieAthletic.com. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
I've been here for about 3 years, been a team lead since 3 months. I love the company. It's a fun place to work. It always keeps you busy every single day. Right off the bat, I told them I wanted a career here. Sure enough, after 3 months, I got promoted. You just gotta make sure that you have the ambition to get there. I can one day see my kid and say, hey, look, I built that trailer. My name is Gabriel, and I am incredibly proud to be part of Stoughton Trailers.
Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
This is Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Adam in the 262, let's not forget when they won the NBA championship, they won when other teams lost key players to injury. I'm not sure the Bucks win that championship if those teams are healthy.
Oh, I'm sure they don't.
But the reason why I read that is that's part of every NBA season. Are the Toronto Raptors winning in 2019? If I think Klay Thompson doesn't go down in the NBA Finals, right?
Which is why KD got hurt that year too.
Which is why that 2019 year hurts me so much for the Bucks, because they were up
2-0
2-0 and Again, that was
4 in a row.
That was a tough one to swallow. So painful. But you got your 2021 one, and you're supposed to be on that upward trajectory.
That's a great point. Have they gone this way since 2021, or have they basically been like this?
Since 2021, it's completely – they haven't even flatlined, right?
Yeah. Nope.
They haven't even
– I guess – back to the Eastern Conference final.
No.
Because then when they lost to Boston, that was before the Eastern Conference Finals, wasn't it?
Yeah, because then they played the Heat.
I think so.
The Boston played the Heat.
Yeah, it was the semis.
And the Heat went to the championship. And the reason why that one was admirable, at least, is because Chris was – playing well before. I remember vividly he slipped and like he slipped on the baseline and so, like in his knee got tweaked, and that is when Giannis had to try and will them, and they did get to a game 7, I believe, against Boston and lost that. 800-990-3776. Diana chimes in. I wish you guys could get Giannis on the show. You want to work on that for us, Diana?
Yeah. For real, though, make it happen.
I saw a comment on our group chat on YouTube. Mad City Brew said this looks a whole lot like the Walter Payton, the Gary Payton trade 2.0.
That was an ultra
painful comment, but it's painful because it feels true.
No, this isn't the same type of thing. This team is in a better position than what we were before. We traded our franchise player. We still have our franchise player. We traded an assistant to the franchise player.
But there's a certain...
Good reference.
There's a certain expectation of who you're getting. Gary Payton was a Hall of Fame level player, and he came here and he was not anything like that.
I mean, Dame averaged 24 points per game this year. His shooting was down a little bit, but I mean...
A little bit.
He obviously was not the same guy, but there's an adjustment period, fellas. There is. He has time that he needs to be able to adjust to being in a new place.
Kyle backpedal Wallace.
No, I'm not Kyle backpedal Wallace. I think were we stupid to believe that Dame can get traded weeks before the training camp opened for the NBA season this year to a place that he did not really want to be and win
a
championship.
He's a professional. And as a professional, it doesn't mean I don't feel for him of what he's going through personally. But when you are getting paid a high amount of money to help a franchise reach its goals, you have to be able to figure it out. Unfair or not.
The Celtics never figured it out last year, and they got bounced.
They're young.
Stop it. They're not young anymore.
They're on the ascend as we were going on this curve of where the Bucks have been since 2021. The trajectory is going the other way for the Boston Celtics.
Boston has been in the conversation for 4 or 5 years.
Yeah,
now.
But when did Giannis win his first championship?
Takes time.
He was 26.
Exactly, and the Tatum Brown is right in that phase right now. And I'm not saying they're going to win, but they have their flaws.
They're the Oklahoma City of the East.
We'll find out. Again, a lot to be seen still as the playoffs get started tonight.
It sure does.
Oh, wow.
Play-ins tonight.
I kind of like the play-in games, actually. Pretty scrappy.
Brad's going to be tuning in, and Diana wants Giannis, so maybe we just need to get our guy Thanasis to book him. Or you can just tune into the Thanasis show and make sure you check out when the Giannis and Thanasis live event goes live on the Thanasis show on YouTube and on podcasts, wherever you get your podcasts. Sit down with special guests. Like we've had Dame on the Thanasis show. We've seen Bobby. We've seen Jordan Love.
Lopez is this way.
Talking about Pokemon. If you're a Pokemon, he's got a haircut in 20 years.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Have you looked at it?
That's 20 years? He's got it.
Subscribe on YouTube, The Thanasis Show, Apple, Spotify, wherever you get your podcasts. It's going to be a great series coming soon. You know, you've seen a lot of teasers from Thanasis about what he's going to put out there. Big guest list coming up for The Thanasis Show. 800-990-3776. 34. Let's go 3 + 4 = 7 for Giannis. Caller number 7 for Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust? You get 15 questions in 90 seconds. And God bless America. Thank you, Brad, for being back, because Kyle did the worst Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust question reading performance I have ever witnessed in my entire life last week. So, Brad, our question asker, is back. You get a chance to win a $25 gift card and beat me in Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust? Caller 7, 800-990-3776. That's 800-990-3776. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Don't go anywhere.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a TurboMax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other Jeep vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
Hi, this is former Badger Pro Football Hall of Famer Joe Thomas. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona Madison. Good Karma Brands radio station.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good afternoon, Madison. My name is Colin Rousseau, and this is your Sports Center update, brought to you by a banner year celebrating the 10-year anniversary of the first of the back-to-back Final Four appearances for Wisconsin men's basketball. All four episode podcasts are now available. Subscribe to the Varsity Podcast on Apple, Spotify, and Wisconsin On Demand. While playoff time is upon us in the NBA, as the Bucks finished the regular season at the third seed in the Eastern Conference, with Giannis officially questionable for the first two games, they will play host to the sixth seed Indiana Pacers. That game one is this coming Sunday at Pfizer. Tip-off is to be determined. Play-in games should be exciting as the Western Conference play-ins. The tip-offs are tonight, with the Lakers and Pelicans leading things off at the seventh seed, and the loser of that game taking on the winner of the later game between the Warriors and the Kings. Those games are tonight, respectively, at 6:30 and 9 p.m. On the Eastern side of things, you've got the Heat taking on the Sixers and the Hawks taking on the Bulls. Those are the Eastern Conference play-in games, tipping off tomorrow at 6 and 8:30. Crew sitting atop the NL Central at 10-5. They're trying to shake a two-game losing streak. They got the Padres tonight at American Family Field with Wade Miley on the mound. First pitch, 6:40.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com. Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studios in Madison, this is Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN. Sponsored by Bud Light on ESPN Wisconsin, ESPN Madison on YouTube, and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Pleasure. That's right. Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust? Led by Brad Nortman this week. Unfortunately, Kyle Wallace. I heard this from multiple people. Plenty of KBN Nation, plenty of people around the office. It was a struggle last week, Kyle. Is that true?
Wasn't my best work. I can admit that. I gave my performance a D-.
A D-?
Yeah, reading is fundamental. And Allegheny and I don't even know what the other river was called. Couldn't get it down. It threw me off.
Well, we all have ways we're humbled. You guys humble me as I return from L.A., and last week Are You Smarter Than humbled you. But I am back, and I'm here to make Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust great again. And this week, once again, we have Chef Ed, caller number 7. As luck would have it, we have Chef Ed as our contestant today for Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust. Chef Ed, how you feeling today?
Yeah, Brad and Kyle. It's kind of a redemption Tuesday for me as well, because I would give myself like an F for last Tuesday. That was an embarrassment on my behalf. I got two.
All right, Chef Ed. Well, we believe in you. Yeah. You've been a longtime fan of the show, so we love us some Chef Ed. And we think that you got what it takes to bring down Ben Brust
Even if you don't bring down Ben Brust, beat yourself from last week. I believe in you.
Yeah.
More than two.
We're just looking for weekly improvement. That's what we're doing, too. Hey, Chris, let's go ahead and spin it.
For those of you who say Ben Brust is an idiot, here's your chance to be proven right. It's time to play Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust?
That's right. This is Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust, which is played by 15 questions in 90 seconds to get as many questions correct as you can. You're allowed to say pass, and we'll come back to it if you get through the rest. Chef Ed, if you beat or tie Ben Brust, you will win a $25 gift card. Any questions before we get started, Chef Ed?
No, Brad, I'm good to go.
All right, let's do this in 3, 2,
move quick,
one.
Move quick.
What year did the Berlin Wall fall?
1950.
What is the capital of India?
New Delhi.
What two countries have the longest shared international border?
Pass.
What is the longest above water mountain range?
Himalayas.
What river runs through Paris?
The Thames.
What country is known as the Land of the Rising Sun?
Japan.
How many feet are in 75 yards?
225.
What animal lies the largest eggs? Lays the largest eggs?
The ostrich.
What is a baby kangaroo called?
A joey.
How long is one regular term for a U.S. representative?
8 years.
The atmosphere of the Earth is divided into how many layers?
3.
The periodic table has how many elements?
Pass.
Which ancient civilization had the practice of foot binding?
The Incas.
Hey!
Okay, that was improvement.
Definitely was improvement. Good job.
Good job, Chef.
Good job.
I got Chef Ed. What was Chef Ed's answer for number? What was it here?
I think he said Japan twice. So
No. It was for what river runs through Paris?
He said the Thames, which is in London, I believe.
Yeah, okay.
Yep. So good guess.
Yep.
Good
so
guess.
Five. He got five.
Hey, good
five. That's
job.
Pretty good, Chef.
And this was not easy, Chef.
No, there it was not easy.
Good job.
I mean, we're talking about the practice of foot binding. I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, I think you got a chance. You did good.
Yep.
You did good. I think it's gonna be close.
That is something. Regardless of how this shakes out, that is something to be proud of.
It is. That's improvement. I like that. He locked in. You did math quickly. I like that.
I mean, we started off with when the Berlin Wall fell.
I was a little nervous.
And
I was a little nervous.
Kyle was very reactive in the studio
19.
Here. Yeah. Ben Brust has now returned.
I mean, but that was a Ben Brust answer, so we'll see.
Yeah, it is.
It sounded like he might have gotten that question before, though.
Yeah.
So we'll see.
That was the longest Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust ever.
No, it's just you were out there with fans talking and you wanted to get back in here. We saw you.
Eager.
Wait, Chef Ed was caller 7?
He sure was.
As luck would have it.
Wait, can he do it 2 weeks in a row?
He didn't win last time, so why not?
I guess.
We were very encouraging of him.
Chef Ed was eager to redeem himself from last week.
Oh, Chef Ed getting roasted on here.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Shouldn't Chef Ed be cooking something? I'm assuming Chef Ed is on again to make Ben look smarter.
People are responding.
Bring
in
it,
there.
Chef Ed. We need a W.
Yeah, good call. The talking text line. No answers coming in, I hope. Reaction to questions.
Has he been cheating this whole time?
No. You guys can hear.
Has
here
he been
go.
Cheating yeah, on
that's,
the talking
that's the
text
difference.
Has he been cheating on the
there
talking
you go.
Text
I just turned
line.
The screen.
Okay, that's
you
true.
You already saw the answer.
There are no
I
answers
I have access
in the
to the talking text line as well. There's no answers in there, and there would have been no answers previously.
Thank
either.
You,
okay.
Chris.
Thank you for keeping.
ESPNWisconsinContest.com.
Chris keeping the
for
integrity of the
rules.
Game high. Okay, it's time to play Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust? 15 questions in 90 seconds. Get as many questions correct as you can. You're allowed to say pass, and we'll come back to it if we get through the rest. If Chef Ed beats you, Ben, he will win a $25 gift card. Any questions?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. 3, 2, 1. In 3, 2, 1. What year did the Berlin Wall fall?
God bless America. 1974.
What is the capital of India?
New Delhi?
Which two countries have the longest shared international border?
Oh, that's easy. Russia and China.
What is the longest above-water mountain range?
Mount Everest?
What river runs through Paris?
The English Channel River.
What country is known as the Land of the Rising Sun?
I feel like we've had this. The Land of the Rising Sun. Pass!
How many feet are in 75 yards?
225.
What animal lays the largest eggs?
Dinosaurs. Just kidding. ostriches. Pass!
What is a baby kangaroo called?
A kangaroo?
Okay. How long is one regular term for a U.S. representative?
2 years.
The atmosphere of the Earth is divided into how many layers?
4.
The periodic table has how many elements?
162.
What ancient civilization had the practice of foot binding?
Huh? Pass.
How many phases does the moon have?
10?
Ooh, it's close.
This is going to be close.
This is close.
Okay, now we had a little bit of controversy.
What?
Yeah,
there's
we
no
do have
controversy.
A controversy.
No, there is.
We have a controversy.
He said yes. Pass.
Because, yeah, because he said.
That was the final answer.
He said
right?
Ostrich and then final answer.
And then he said pass.
He said pass.
So he does not get it. He passed
on
no,
the no, I said final answer.
And then you said pass.
But yep. Pass does not surpass final answer.
Yes,
no, but
it does.
It was your
say,
final
what do you mean?
Injection of the answer.
You wrote, you filled in the circle, and then you X'd it out after. That's what you did.
It's still going to go through on the Scantron.
No, you X'd it out. So
yeah, you erased
see.
It.
Yeah,
you erased your answer.
You, why are
pass.
You guys against me?
We not. Well, you said pass.
So we're saying if he did pass,
tie.
Then he lost 5-4.
Oh, you lost.
But if he did get the right answer and didn't pass, then it tied 5-5.
He lost. He passed. That was stupidity. You had it. You said dinosaur, and he
stupidity,
said ostrich.
Dang.
You said ostriches, and he said ostrich. And he said, no, pass.
You know, this is Rich coming from someone who's stupid and wouldn't be able to do any of this.
I mean, these were tough questions.
They were tough questions.
I could have got 4.
Either way, Chef Ed's getting his $25 gift card. Good job, Chef Ed. Redeeming yourself. So, but for the record standpoint,
look at him. He looks salty.
Yeah.
Look at him.
Chef Ed beat you, Ben.
Chef Ed beat you. I'm telling you, this is.
Are you guys going to sleep good tonight? Just like,
great.
You guys feel good?
I'm going to sleep great.
The rematch.
I am rent-free in both of your heads.
Oh. So we're calling this a loss, right? Because
this is an L.
His final answer was pass.
That was a clear L. He knows he passed.
Yeah.
He knows
he's just trying to weasel his way out of it.
If it would have been for a win, I'd still be talking.
That's fair. Okay, let's run through these. Let's run through these answers. What year did the Berlin Wall fall? Chef Ed said 1950.
I thought we were doomed.
Kyle, off the bat. Kyle took off his headset and walked away.
I thought we were doomed.
He had to walk that one off.
How is Chef Ed was alive when it happened?
Yeah.
He was alive and well when it happened.
We don't know if he was well, but he was alive.
But he was alive. You don't remember watching that on TV or hearing about it? 1950, yeah. Maybe not. 1989, it happened, bro. You were alive.
That's true.
Is he on the phone?
Because yeah. It was 1989.
Chef
he's
Ed,
still there, yeah.
Chef Ed, what?
Yeah, he's still there.
Chef Ed, what? Do you not remember that happening in 1989?
Well, now I remember after the fact.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes
yeah.
It's a little bit of pressure. And I want to put a big asterisk by my win, because I would have took ostrich from Benny, so I'm going to put an asterisk on my win. I think he tied me.
A man of integrity.
No,
he's not out to get me.
We run a tighter
he
game than that, Chef Ed.
He said pass, Chef Ed. You can't say final answer and then say pass. What are you passing to?
Don't let him
to?
Off the
keep
hook,
on
Chef
going,
Ed.
Boys.
All right. What is the capital of India? New Delhi. You guys both got that one right. I learned something new today. What two countries have the longest shared international border? U.S. and Canada.
Oh, wow.
Fascinating, right? Didn't know that. I thought your guess of India or
China
and
Russia
was brilliant.
I thought it was good. I thought it was someone in Brazil.
But U.S., Canada.
Is the globe lying to me?
I don't know. You know, it's like...
It's flat.
I'd say it's glow.
Kyle famously
globe,
became
so.
A flat earther last week.
Yeah,
while
that's
you're
what
gone,
the sun.
Brad.
That's what happened when I looked into the sun. I realized the Earth was flat. I didn't see a horizon.
Moving on. What is the longest above water mountain range? The Andes. The Andes.
The good candy.
Good candy after
not candy, but good like mint after
refreshing post meal.
A restaurant that gives them away.
The river that runs through Paris. Is not the English Channel River. It's the Seine. The Seine River.
Now, why
Seine,
would
the Seine.
Seine. Seine.
See? See?
Seine.
Reading
Seine,
is hard.
Seine. It is.
It's
yeah.
very hard.
It's French.
I don't know what mine was last week, but the show wasn't American.
You mean English?
I think Allegheny.
I said what I said. No, the other word other than Allegheny.
There was another word
there
other than Allegheny that he couldn't say.
Oh, neither of us could say it.
But Chris, do you remember the word? If not, I'll go back and watch
it. Started
the
with
film.
An M.
Yeah, it was with an M. It was, I got to go look it
mahogany?
Up.
Mahogany? Okay.
No, I know how to say mahogany.
I'll go back and look it up. I'll keep this thing rolling. What country is known as Land of the Rising Sun? That is Japan. You passed that one. Chef Ed got that one right. How many feet are in 75 yards? Good quick math for both of you. Multiply that times 3 is 225. The animal that lays the largest eggs. This was the point of controversy. Chef Ed got it right with ostrich, and Ben passed it.
It was the Monongahela River.
Oh.
Monongahela River.
Okay, I would struggle with that one, too.
You don't even know what the Monongahela was. Read it. What is it? Read the question.
Kyle, what are you doing? I like it better when you take the segment off.
From
We're running late now because of you.
Brust, in what city do the Allegheny and Mahunga-Nila.
Thank you. That threw me off.
Rivers meet from the Ohio River. I mean, that's
why I got a D plus.
Allegheny, I could maybe get, but that one is rough.
Thank you.
Turn his mic off for real. Pat him down.
What is a baby kangaroo called? It's called a Joey. You just said kangaroo. I thought you were asking for clarification.
No, I know. I didn't know. But sometimes there's some trick questions in here.
It's a Joey. How long is the regular term for a U.S. representative? 2 years. Very impressive, Ben.
Very impressive.
The atmosphere, it's true. The atmosphere of the Earth is divided into how many layers? Did you guess four and get this one right?
I guessed four.
I think you got it right. The periodic table has how many elements? 118. What ancient civilization had the practice of foot binding? Does anyone know what
Aztecs.
Ancient China.
Yeah.
What is foot binding?
It's basically you bandage the woman's foot to like make it more pleasingly more aesthetic.
Is this a fifth grade question?
Mike.
Basically to like reshape them.
Wow.
Alter the shape.
How many phases does the moon have? Eight.
Justin in the 262, the official Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust question grader, says Kyle saying stupidity is comedy. Look in the mirror.
Oh, give him 15, by the way.
Brad.
Let me look at 15. As you're reading that, I'll give you 15.
Brad, you get a C grade with the Ben hate. Ben should have tied. Justice for Ben. Thank you, Justin.
Don't be soft out there, KBN Nation.
My God.
So soft.
Justin loses all credibility. He is fired from grading based off that comment.
That is a fireable comment. We hold this game to a high degree of integrity, and a final answer a final answer.
That's the guy
y'all can't read.
That's the guy who's grading me?
Some integrity.
The guy that said, the dude that heard the dude say pass and
Chris,
it's been a
his
tie.
Mic, okay. Please.
Final question for Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust? If you get this right, I'll give you the tie. How about that?
Hell no.
Okay.
I have more integrity than both of you.
Who was the first Chief Justice of the United States?
More Kyle Brust and Nortman on the other side.
You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN.
Craig Council bobblehead that was given away, and we, just did a nice, soliloquy? Is that the right word?
Yeah, like a montage.
Like a Virgil.
We did a vigil.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Ben Brust here from Kyle Brust and Nortman and tell you about the newest spike tea on the market, and that is Hoop Tea. And when I mean that it's the newest and best, it was born on the boardwalk of Ocean City, Maryland, and enjoyed now right here in Madison, Wisconsin. With flavors like an original spike tea. You have peach, you have mango, you have watermelon. Hoop Tea will make you feeling great with whatever flavor fits your profile. Hoop Tea. Enjoy the hoops on the screen and hoops in your hand. HoopTea.com. Must be 21 years or older to enjoy.
Now's the time to make those big spring purchases at Fleet Farm. Husqvarna mowers, Minn Kota trollers, Goodyear tires. Fleet Rewards credit card members can enjoy special financing for 3 full years on qualifying purchases. So don't wait. There's never been a better time to get everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. 36-month special financing available on in-store purchases of $1,499 or more after discounts made with your Fleet Rewards credit card. Now through May 1st, 2024. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See customer service for details.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at 2 convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Wild Rock Golf in the Wisconsin Dells, a must-play every golf season. Wild Rock Golf features championship golf in the heart of Wisconsin. Wild Rock, a Herdston Fry masterpiece that's cut from the natural beauty of the Wisconsin Dells and offers stunning views from elevated tee boxes. Wild Rock presents spectacular greens that roll fast and true. Wild Rock Golf in the Wisconsin Dells, a unique gem that offers a challenge to avid golfers of all abilities. Book your tee time today for this must-play at wildrockgolf.com. WildRockGolf.com.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Why are interscholastic sports called the last classroom of the day? Because they teach students important life lessons like teamwork, accountability, and perseverance.
Encourage your student to participate in the last classroom of the day. Interscholastic sports in Wisconsin.
This is Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, sponsored by Bud Light on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
If you want to hear a weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend, you need to turn in to Hear District. Marcus Johnson is a former Bucks legend, and he is joined by Marcus is joined by his son Chris, also a 1995 UCLA hoops champion himself, and they talk all things happening in the Bucks world. And they're joined by some of the biggest names in basketball. They also answer your questions too. This is a Bucks Plus audio production, the Hear District. Stay on the beat of the Bucks and find out Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Shout out to all the Benny believers out there who are making it very clear that it is complete nonsense of my co-host to not have my back. And are you smarter than Ben Brust?
Shameful.
But 17-8-1, I'm still very much above 500 and looking good heading into the summer months of the Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust at 3 p.m. on Tuesdays.
Kyle Brust and Nortman. Vacation, you better watch out. The competition's going to be stiffer.
You're saying the dummies go on vacation?
No, the people who are smart are taking more vacations and they're probably listening and they're not at work as much. Just wait on it, buddy.
I figured the 3 p.m. slot would be tough because of the teachers.
Yeah,
but maybe they don't get out of school around that.
Teachers have summers off. Them L's is coming.
We need some fifth grade teachers to call in.
We do.
We should recruit some fifth grade teachers in the area.
That's how desperate you are for me to lose. That's how sad your lives are.
We did have a teacher call us last week while he was supposed to be working.
That's true. Yes, it's true. 800-990-3776. 800-990-ESPN. Streaming on YouTube at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee. Ben Brust, Kyle Wallace, and Brad Nortman. And I don't know. We talked about Jair Alexander showing up, but yesterday on the Green Bay Packers social, QB1 walked in the building, and Kyle had a smile on his face.
Yeah, man. Seeing Jordan Love walk around here like he is the man, made me feel so filled with happiness and joy inside because of the fact that the swagger that he is displaying, the way he is walking, the confidence that he has when he moves, it is a whole world difference than
the opposite of what I look like or what you look like at work.
Yeah, okay, whatever you say. But we didn't see all this last year. This year, he is the unquestioned leader of this team. When I saw him walking in, it made me believe that the budding star for the Green Bay Packers in Jordan Love is now the new Giannis of the Wisconsin sports. And I say that because right now we're questioning Giannis' leadership. We're talking about if the Bucks don't make it out the first round, will Giannis leave? Giannis, at this point, has a little bit more drama that comes with him, which is leaning more towards Rodgers. He is not anywhere close to Rodgers. But the infatuation phase of everybody being so happy with Giannis, it seems to go away right now.
Right now, it is all about the season of Jordan Love, and I believe that Jordan Love is on his pathway right now to being Giannis, to being the beloved star of Wisconsin. He has the loyalty. He's happy to be back in Green Bay. He's coming to this offseason program. He also has the skill set and the talent that you need in order to be a superstar. He has the personality. We got to see more of that personality this offseason when he was going on different podcasts, like the Analysis podcast, and also the thing that Wisconsin and nice love about their superstars is the positivity. Jordan Love has absolutely everything, and on top of that, like I said, he has the talent, and he's going to get this team back to a championship. It is now Jordan Love's state.
Adam in the 608 chiming in on Kyle. Justin the 262, how many bad takes can Kyle have? Well, let's just put it on the poll. Who do you like more? I already can say this. I like both is going to be commented, but who do you like more? Giannis or Jordan Love? And it's up for your interpretation on how you want to answer.
How quickly your heart shifts from one love to the
He's
other,
He's Mr.
Kyle.
Emotional roller coaster wreck.
Wait a
listen,
minute.
Listen.
Keyword wreck.
You sound like you're still in the honeymoon phase with Jordan Love, right? I mean, I get it. You get into a new relationship. It's exciting. You haven't had your first big fight yet, and everything seems like it's rosy and up and to the right. But the reality is you haven't gone through many tough things together. You haven't had many milestones together. So how can you possibly shift your affection from Giannis, who brought this city and this state a championship?
A 50-year drought. And this guy claims to be what, Brad?
I love Giannis.
Our 414 guy.
I love Giannis.
Oh, I love Giannis.
You are dethroning him after one season.
This is fraud, Kyle. This is when you become a fraud.
I love
when you say how you feel and then backpedal.
I love me some Giannis, but I'm telling y'all, the smile, the emotions, that tingly feeling that I got inside when I saw Jordan Love on Twitter, I said, that is my
The honeymoon phase
that's
goes
lust.
Away.
That's not
No, that's not lust. That is absolutely love. We went from Favre to Rodgers, Rodgers to Giannis, and right now that transitioning is happening from Giannis to Love. When we get to December of next year, when the Green Bay Packers are competing for the number one seed in the NFC, competing for an NFC North title, everybody in this state is going to love. Jordan Love is
800-990-3776. John in the 414. Isn't Kyle the only one hating on Giannis right now? Don't drag the rest of us with you.
How am I hating on Giannis?
You're the only one that's
questioned his leadership. You say he's the problem in where the Bucks are at right now, and now you're saying Jordan Love is Giannis.
Yeah, listen, that is a compliment to Giannis that's saying somebody is taking over.
Jordan Love is Giannis now.
Now. He's the man.
That's dethroning Giannis.
That is past tensing Giannis.
Giannis.
All right. The philosopher Kyle Wallace comes back out.
The window is closing in front of our eyes. We all see it. We can't sit here and Ben be concerned about if the Bucks don't win, he may leave. You be concerned about what's going on and saying, well, it's not his leadership, but he also hasn't done the best. We all feel disjointed about the Bucks. Where's your energy towards the Green Bay Packers? Where's the energy
It's because your heart hasn't been broken by this team yet and that quarterback yet. When it does, you're not going to be so quick to say that, because this was the same thing with Giannis. We were giving him the crown when everything was optimistic, positive. But he has deposited enough goodwill to be able to weather a little bit of the storms. He still is the guy that brought the city, the state, a championship after a 50-year drought, two-time MVP. He is a guy that is one of the faces of the NBA. Jordan Love has to get me at least to a Super Bowl and be in the MVP conversation before I'm saying anything about to Giannis.
Y'all don't remember when Aaron Rodgers took over and he had his first season, everybody fell in love with Aaron Rodgers. Now, granted, we didn't have a basketball player other than probably Michael Redd at that time, so he was able to get that crown right from Brett Favre. But what we have seen from Giannis is that there is something off about this team, and that also includes Giannis as well, to the fact that you guys are concerned he may not be around for too much longer.
800.
I am jumping on the Love train right now.
Yeah, and he's off the Giannis train. 800-990-3776. Thanasis Anadokounmpo, welcome into Kyle Brust and Nortman to respond to Kyle.
You lie.
Mike and Kenosha, what up?
Oh, I will say, dang.
How you doing?
Doing good. How are you?
Hey. How are you guys going to skip over? You go from Favre to Rodgers.
Don't Giannis, do you guys. Call Kyle out, please.
Okay. Kyle, how are you going to skip over Ryan Braun and those great years that the Brewers had keeping us in the playoffs? I can't believe you just skipped over Ryan Braun.
He
no
calls
Braun
himself
love.
A 414
so,
guy.
So what you're saying is that Ryan Braun was the king of Wisconsin for a while.
Absolutely. So was Frank the Tank.
Over
Aaron Rodgers, though?
Yeah, because Aaron Rodgers and Braun were at the same time. They're going to open up a restaurant before somebody got caught trying to dilute some stuff.
You can just say doing PEDs. I mean, I guess he's still probably trying to get away from that story and pretending it never happened.
Yeah. Poor Ryan Braun, huh?
Oh, you feel bad?
Yeah, man.
Feels bad for Ryan Braun.
You do not, we'll you do support not feel
Brett,
bad for...
We'll support Brett Favre to the very end,
no.
But has now made Giannis public enemy number one in Wisconsin.
Ryan Braun, like Lance Armstrong to that guy.
No. I don't.
For real.
Okay, let me just say, I feel bad that
you've Ryan said a lot.
Ryan Braun, listen, I feel bad for the guy that he kind of, very, very offensive.
He ruined him.
Well, for a short moment, he did.
Yeah, could you imagine that?
He accused him of being a hater, and so... I like Ryan Braun, okay? I'm loyal.
Also, we learned he's a flat earther. He's an OJ guy. What else can we learn about
that? Wait a minute.
I got to tell you about Road America. Road America is America's national park of speed, and you need to make the most out of your summer by making your plans now to get to Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. It is a 14-turn road course, and it's not just about racing. You can camp on-site all weekend and long and enjoy free admission for kids 16 and under. With a paying adult at the gate, and the NTT IndyCar Series is coming June 6th through the 9th. So come for the experience, stay for the race, get your tickets at roadamerica.com. They have the Family Fun Zone. If you love the racing, you got to get to Turn 5. The action will be there. The action will be on the track, off the track. The food is amazing. Everything you need is at Road America. Go to roadamerica.com to get your tickets for the NTT IndyCar Series race coming in June. We'll see what bad take Kyle has next.
This is Kyle Brust and Nortman.
So they are lucky. Those other teams, whether it's Kentucky or whether it's Oregon or was it TCU?
That's TCU.
TCU, they're lucky I didn't play in that game. You got upset by a bad team, TCU.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Now's the time to make those big spring purchases at Fleet Farm. Husqvarna mowers, Minn Kota trollers, Goodyear tires. Fleet Rewards credit card members can enjoy special financing for 3 full years on qualifying purchases. So don't wait. There's never been a better time to get everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. 36-month special financing available on in-store purchases of $1,499 or more after discounts made with your Fleet Rewards credit card. Now through May 1st, 2024. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See customer service for details.
Listen to Madison Money Guy every Saturday morning at 7 a.m. on 100.5 ESPN and ESPNWisconsin.com.
I like to refer to inflation as the silent killer. It's an invisible risk. It's just the idea that things get more expensive over time. You're going to need milk and eggs when you're in your early 60s and when you're in your early 80s. You're going to get a loaf of bread, and it's going to be more expensive 20 years from now.
Christian Finfrock is the Madison Money Guy. Call him today at 208-1800.
Goodman's Jewelers has been providing a sparkle to Madison since 1933. That's a lot of great memories. John Hayes for Goodman's Jewelers. We've been caring for generations of customers, and during that time, our strengths have been trust, service, and selection. Those traits are who we are, and that will never change. Goodman's Jewelers, a destination worth reaching. 220 State Street, goodmansjewelers.com.
The best is at Goodman's.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last-minute Lisa, we'll make your last-minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
This update is sponsored by UW Credit Union. For every stage of life, UW Credit Union is here for every you. Fans, here's your Quick Trip to the Ballpark ticket offer. Spend $200 at participating Quick Trip locations and get a free Terrace Reserve ticket to a 2024 Brewers home game. Check brewers.com/quicktrip for more details. Join UW Credit Union at uwcu.org. Insured by NCUA.
Your first round pick is here. Unleash unbeatable deals at Metro Kia of Madison. Get into a 2024 Kia Forte at 3.9% APR financing for 48 months. $22.53 per thousand borrowed. This deal available to qualified credit. Offers on the 2024 Kia Seltos include 4.75% APR financing for 48 months. $22.92 per thousand borrowed. Before April hits the final round, score today at Metro Kia of Madison. Browse inventory at MetroKiaMadison.com.
The host might be irrelevant, but the conversations aren't.
Bears defensive end Montez Sweat earlier this week on a podcast with Chris Long.
I'm not losing to Green Bay this year. I can't do it.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe.
Instead of hanging out in the Bahamas and enjoying his offseason, he's complaining about the Packers. Rent free.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe. Live on ESPN Madison's YouTube every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And available wherever you get your podcasts.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
This is Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, sponsored by Bud Light on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
I was born in a city where the winter nights don't ever sleep. So this life.
The Princeton Club's a fantastic place for you to get your health where it needs to go. Why are you whispering something in Brad's ear?
Jeez Louise, insecurity. What?
Well, you guys gang up with me and are you smarter than Ben Brust? I got my antennas up.
Oh, no, we love you, man.
But it's always a great time to join the Princeton Club, whether you're in Milwaukee or Madison. They have locations for you. New Berlin and Milwaukee's been fantastic for me. Find your better tomorrow by having the courage to walk in there, get a tour, and you'll be like, wow, free childcare with the membership? It's open 24/7? There's no better time to start investing in your health than right now. So have the courage, go in there, and join the Princeton Club. Anything you'd like to share with the group?
No.
Kyle, Brustin, Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin.
We talked about it off air.
Okay, sounds good.
Having our conversation.
Okay.
About
all
money.
All right. About money?
Yeah. A fine being more than something else.
Oh, we're going to leave that one alone. 800-990-3776. Kyle, Brustin, Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. So Kyle has planted his flag as the utmost Giannis Antetokounmpo hater.
I stopped him from saying that.
I still feel like we need a little bit of a follow-up there. So what's required to be the king of Wisconsin sports? Because it feels like the crown has been passed with too much ease.
See,
doesn't seem right to do that to Giannis.
What I do is I evaluate things and I look at how things are going. And just because I'm passing the crown from Giannis to Jordan Love does not mean I still don't love Giannis.
You just don't love him as much.
No, I still love Giannis. But what I'm saying is just like people have their favorites, Jordan Love is becoming one of my favorites. Everything about dude, swagger, the feel, the vibe.
Kyle's
that I got,
poor kids are going to be power ranked every day of the week.
Hey, if that's what brings the greatness out of them, then you know what? That's what my little kids are going to have to deal with. But when I look at this, when I see Giannis, I get happiness. When I see him perform, him meme mug, I'm like, that's my guy. That's the guy that I get to cheer for. I'm excited for myself. But me just simply seeing Jordan Love walk in on Twitter got me excited about
he's googly-eyed. No, you called it.
No,
you
called what is it? To come? And listen, the thing is this. What negative thing can we say about Jordan Love off the field?
But hold on. He's been a part of the Wisconsin sport reality for less than 12 months. And it seems like you are dinging guys. You're discrediting them the longer they play.
Oh, my gosh.
And did we not see the Giannis documentary that went out on Amazon? If anything,
love Giannis.
I love Giannis. Yeah. Because you
don't. Rodgers out of the way, ready to move on. Giannis, it seems like the longer they're here, no matter what they've done, those deposits don't mean anything. And we're ready to switch to somebody who's been less of a known commodity
for
12
months.
If I was
a bank and Kyle Wallace came into the bank, he's probably going to switch from banks when he gets just the next best offer, even if it might not be great for long term. He's just
going right with what he feels in the moment.
Now, I do drop credit cards a lot.
If you're going to try to sell Giannis stock high to buy Jordan Love stock low, I can understand that argument. But to say that Jordan Love stock should be worth more than Giannis stock,
listen,
that's
what I'm
not
saying.
On
I'm
Twitter at KBN ESPN, who do you like more, Jordan Love or Giannis Antetokounmpo? Jordan Love 35%, Giannis 65%. Mark chimes in, Giannis has proven himself to be loyal to our city and our state, truly wants to win. Let's hope outsiders don't get in his head and tell him he has to leave like LeBron did to Cleveland.
I love Giannis. They're both up here.
No.
They're both way
whenever
up here.
I love Giannis, you have to turn his mic off because he needs to be consistent with what comes out of his
mouth. I never once said I didn't. I'm just simply saying the crown is being passed. It is happening in front of our eyes that the crown is being passed to Jordan Love. Brad, repeat what you said yesterday about what
If the Packers have a down season, which is like it's the NFL, the season hasn't started, they have to go through the draft. If they finish 8-9, in Jordan Love's second year. Where's Jordan Love compared to Giannis? Because Giannis brought you a title for the first time
in
50 years.
That would mean I was too quick to switch over, but I don't think I was too quick to switch over.
Because, Kyle, you're correct. All the current players at the NFL media workshop combine that I was at in L.A., we're saying the Green Bay Packers,
cool,
they are young, they are good, they're talented, and Jordan Love's the real deal. I get that, but with that being
Jordan Love is the real deal.
With that being said, Stephen A. Smith went on Thanalysis and called Giannis a top three player in the world. No one was saying that Jordan Love's a top three quarterback in the world.
What a tease to a new episode that'll be coming out here soon on YouTube for the Thanalysis show.
Yeah, that's a tease.
Listen, you can say what you want to say, but at the
you
end
must
of the
have
day,
been at the live event with Giannis.
I
and
must have been. What a lovely event it was.
I mean, anybody could have told you that.
Had a couple carblesses, you know.
I sure did. They were delicious.
But Jordan Love is an ascending player. Again, Giannis is a great player, and I'm not. Again, this is not taking anything from Giannis except for the crown of Jordan Love being the guy.
Yeah, football. Not taking anything from Giannis except for being king of the state.
When we talk about sports here in Wisconsin, football is king. Packers are king. And Jordan Love is about to be the king of the NFC. And so with that, I'm just telling y'all, it is slowly moving over to Jordan Love.
Yeah, but you're saying slowly, and you're trying to be ahead of it, when the right answer right now from everyone is you can't pass the crown to somebody who has yet to accomplish anything great.
Kyle.
And in your words for the Green Bay Packers, great is not just getting to the playoffs and winning one game and falling short to the Niners.
The crown sits on someone's head.
Thank you, Derwin, by the way.
Whose head does it sit on?
Whose head does it sit on now?
Yes.
It still sits on Giannis' head for now.
Oh, my God. Kyle backpedal Wallace.
But I'm telling y'all.
That's for you all,
you put the crown on his head. What I'm doing is this, y'all. I'm hovering over Giannis's head, right? You know how LeBron had the whole thing about king me, crown me, whatever it is. He had the graphic. I'm sitting over Giannis's head, and I'm slowly putting my head on the crown, and I'm getting ready to move it to Jordan Love. I'm in the process of moving the crown
Put it on Jackson Churio next.
Yeah, seriously. The Prince crown.
No, I'm
15 games into his Brewers career. He's ready to
put
Jackson Churio over Giannis.
Mark it and save it. Y'all question my love for Jordan Love with him being a potential Hall of Famer, and then Brad goes and talks to current NFL players.
Mitch chimes in. Kyle backpedal Wallace strikes again.
And he finds out that he may be a Hall of Famer. I told you about Jackson Churio.
Yeah, but Giannis,
Giannis
is a Hall of Famer.
I'm an early adopter.
Jordan Love might be.
He wasn't even rookie of the – or I guess he was a first-year starter.
I'm an early adopter.
He wouldn't have beat C.J. Stroud.
I don't think he would have.
Fellas, I see greatness. That's all I'm saying. I see what's happening. I'm telling y'all. I see what's happening. You guys
see
it,
too. Are you blind?
We all see it, too. You wouldn't be questioning if this team was going to go to the finals if you truly believed in Giannis. That is what I'm saying. The belief – in the Packers, the belief in Jordan Love
if he wasn't hurt, I still would be able to make an argument that he has the ability to will this team.
But you wouldn't believe it, though. You couldn't say it with conviction. But when we
and I can't say with conviction that Jordan Love is going to be the reason why the Packers win a Super Bowl in the next 2 years, because that's too outlandish to say.
If the Packers win a Super Bowl in the next 2 years, who's the one player that you believe will lead that?
I mean, obviously Jordan Love.
And do you think it's a possibility?
not as high as I do when Giannis is on the floor for the Bucks.
How about this
even
one?
With where they're at?
Kyle.
He's won them a championship.
And we've regressed ever since.
They haven't been to the Super Bowl in 15 years. And putting stock in 10 games over what Giannis has done over the course of his career is just too emotional. Okay. You are an emotional wreck.
Just wait on it.
If Giannis and Jordan Love are at the same event, same autograph signing, who has a longer line?
Jordan Love.
Oh, my gosh.
No, hey, really, though. For real, though. It depends on
Kyle
where you're
sounds
at.
Like Skip Bayless.
It depends on where
Swap
you're
Kyle
at.
Swap Kyle and Tori. Well, lucky for you, Tori's with us at 4.
It depends on where you're at, right? I mean, Giannis is a huge star. He's a huge star.
No. And just not because Giannis is a huge star, because you can't say anything good about Giannis because it's now fraudulent. Kyle backpedal walls.
Don't you do this to me with
now,
Giannis.
What you
don't
should
you
do
this. And Tony, don't you send no clips to Tenacity today. We're not doing that.
Producer of Thanalysis Show, Tony Cartagena, if you aren't listening, I will be sending you this segment and the segment before. And if you missed any of it, Wisconsin On Demand, so you can hear Giannis get taken out again by Kyle Wallace.
Absolutely
and you know
not.
I love Pottawatomie Casino Hotel, and I genuinely love it. I won't stop loving it because it will always be there, like Giannis has been for the Milwaukee Bucks, and then like Kyle can see that. I love going over the cash in a winning ticket, and it will be my place to go to now and forever because they are adding a 2,000-square-foot video wall, luxury seating for over 200, an expanded food menu, and I am loyal. I am loyal to winners, and that's what we're going to make you with some of these Ben Same Game parlays, although it's not a guaranteed thing. We've been doing really well. Pottawatomie Sportsbook's going to be next level. Don't miss the grand opening the first week of May. Mark your calendars because a new era of sports betting is here. Paysbig.com. That's paysbig.com. Whew. I don't even know where to go after Kyle just took out the man with the crown.
Oh, my gosh. All this slander.
We're going to talk during the break, and we'll have Kyle hopefully write up an apology letter for everything he just said next.
I'm going to get an attorney for you.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
We've called him Whitey Tighties. We've called him the hall monitor. He's Jesse Nelson. Like, he's just, I am Jesse Nelson. Kyle, you're Jesse Nelson.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
Varsity on Wisconsin On Demand is home to all the latest and best Badgers content on ESPN Wisconsin. Subscribe on Apple, Spotify, Wisconsin On Demand, and wherever you get your podcasts. Wisconsin men's hockey senior goaltender Kyle McClellan has been named the winner of the 2024 Mike Richter Award, which is given to the nation's top Division I men's goaltender. McClellan went 24-12-1 on the season, posting 7 shutouts and a .931 save percentage. In its 11th year, this is the first time a Wisconsin goaltender has been awarded the Mike Richter Award, who played for Wisconsin from 1985 to 1987 and won a Stanley Cup with the New York Rangers in 1994.
Get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months. Book before April 30th at PellaWI.com.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at 2 convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
Tee off this summer at Prairie Pines Golf Club in Sun Prairie. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher. Enjoy the ultimate golf experience at Prairie Pines with a range of membership options, from unlimited access to weekdays only. Whether you're a golf enthusiast or just a casual golfer, Prairie Pines has something for everyone. Just passing through? No worries. Guests are always welcome. Visit PrairiePinesGolfClub.com to book your tee time and learn more about golf memberships for the entire 2024 season. That's PrairiePinesGolfClub.com.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
I may have lost Are You Smarter Than Ben Brust on our show. You can always go back to WisconsinOnDemand.com. Kyle, Brust, and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. But win or loss, screaming Sicilian pizza. And I did that. The girlfriend's family. Of course, they came in town. One of the things, frozen pizza Friday. So we thought we'd do a little frozen pizza. I went to my local grocer, and I got the mustache pizza, a.k.a. pizza, with that stone fire crust with whole milk mozzarella cheese sourced right here in Wisconsin in the secret tomato recipe sauce. I got the OG Screamin's. You know, you got the thin and crispy tavern style, 2.5 feet of stuffed crust cheese. But I went OG for them because it's got all the best toppings in the world. We had a Boss Hog. We had a Supremus Maximus. You also have the Ultimate Deluxe. You have the Holy Pepperoni, the Bester's Revenge. But guess what I saved for when we came back late for a little late night snacking? The Mambo Italiano!
Mambo!
We found our screaming pleasure. And you can taste what all the screaming is about. Kyle, Brust, and Nortman. I'm Ben Brust alongside Kyle Wallace. Kyle Backpedal Wallace, excuse me. And Brad Nortman. 800-990-3776. Again, 800-990-ESPN. And the best way that we can summarize what had happened was...
defamation. That's the best way. Defamation.
Is ultimately when Brad said, who still has the crown? Giannis or Jordan Love? Kyle? Despite saying that Jordan Love is Giannis now, he still chose Giannis. Because when he visualized what Giannis means and what Giannis has done for the city, for the state, staying here, being loyal, bringing a championship to Milwaukee for the first time in 50 years.
You guys don't see what I'm talking about.
We have a body of work from Giannis that has made me realize that I need to see the body of work from Jordan Love before I'm just going to be in lust like Brad said you were, and I think he's right.
That Jordan Love King Crown needs to be earned, and earned over several seasons with winning. That means winning divisions, winning NFC championships, and winning Super Bowls. Giannis has done that over and over.
Or just say Super Bowl, because even the other quarterbacks only have one.
Super Bowl, that's true. And I view it like Game of Thrones. Style. It can't just be like, oh, here's a casual, I'm going to take this crown to your head. It's got to be, you got to take out the other king to
be able
to put that on your head.
So graphic.
I mean, and no one's saying that Jordan Love's going to do that to Giannis, but that just goes to show how important that is, that Giannis has to be fully washed to be that guy where it's like, okay, it's
how
clear
quickly
that's the
he moved on.
So quickly.
I mean, when Giannis wasn't even the king of the state, when Aaron Rodgers was still here, fellas, he wasn't.
Yeah, but Aaron Rodgers was here for at least 10 years, 8 years before.
He won a title, and he still wasn't king. I'm telling you.
Yes, but time out. What you're saying is not fair to the timeline. Rodgers won a Super Bowl in 10. Then they were 15-1. And then he had two MVPs even before Giannis was here. Then Giannis comes here. He had to build his career. And at that point, obviously the Packers are huge in the state. And Rodgers went on a run in 2019, 2020. in 2020, they were huge.
It was
they were the best offense in the NFL, the best red zone offense in the NFL. Yeah. They lost to the Buccaneers in the NFC Championship game, and then Giannis won their championship in 2021. So to put Giannis ahead of Rodgers was near impossible because of what Rodgers had done for the state over a long period of time.
It's a cumulative resume that helps take the king's crown and put it on your head. You can't be too quick to take it off. Jordan Love has to do much more on his resume to actually be able to take that. Right now, he's just a prince. Dude's a prince, not a king yet.
800-990-3776. Ron in the Key chimes in. Again, I appreciate Kyle reclaiming the Giannis and Thanasis hater crown. Well, again, he's not reclaiming anything. This is who he's been. He's been consistent with it, which is what I appreciate.
This is terrible. This is this slander.
This is what you said.
I'm telling
we have slander.
One call, that's all. Guru Law Office Studio. I am making one call, that's all, after this show, because this is defamation of my hair.
I think you only pay if they win, and you're not going to win this defamation case because we have audio of you saying all this stuff.
Well, it's true. I mean, again, you guys, I understand what you're saying. Giannis is obviously huge, but again, this is Packer country. This state is all about the Green Bay Packers, and we are all excited about what is to come with Jordan Love. Jordan Love is our guy. He's the number one player. He is the franchise quarterback. When Jordan Love gets on that field this fall and he's slinging that ball, and as Ben says, slanging pills everywhere left and right, everybody's going to love Jordan Love, and everybody's still going to like Giannis, but everybody in this state is going to be talking about how great Jordan Love is. I'm just giving him the crown now because I can see what's happening.
So all it takes is one capable year of a starting quarterback for the Green Bay Packers to overthrow your Hall of Famer, two-time MVP.
It takes for what I see the potential in the future is. You guys have ridden the Milwaukee Bucks off already. You guys have ridden them off already.
That doesn't take away.
It does definitely take away. If you don't believe in your franchise player to lead your team to
bad
a championship
title. Bad
season
for Giannis. He brought us a championship for the first time in 50 years. Forget him. Jordan Love, 10 straight games of being a great quarterback. Oh, I love him. He's better than Giannis has ever been to all of us. It's like you forgot where you lived and where you grew up.
It's not that I forgot where I live and I grew up, but I know what this state loves. We love our quarterbacks. Our quarterbacks are stars. You don't go from Brett Favre to Aaron Rodgers, and then when you have the next great quarterback, that he isn't going to be beloved as well. This is nothing against Giannis. This is speaking volumes to what Jordan Love is going to become.
Takes a lot longer.
You have 60 seconds before the 414 hour to take any. This is your last chance to take back anything that you've said.
Well,
you're good at backpedaling.
As I said this whole time, when it comes down to it, KBN Nation, I love me some Giannis. But what I'm telling you is that he is being dethroned in front of our eyes by Jordan Love. Jordan Love will be the man in this state, and I'm just putting my print on it now that Jordan Love is the new man of this state. He's the king of Wisconsin, fellas.
What's the song, "These Bleep Ain't Loyal"? That's Kyle, actually.
Oh, wow. Never, don't call me that.
Never thought I'd see
you.
You
call me a garden tool?
Exactly right.
I am not a garden tool.
Garden tool.
You're acting like it.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow is right. That's and speaking of, and powerful, that's Tory Lowe on a Tory Lowe Tuesday. Coming up next, you got Religion Hamilton and Madison, but we'll be back in 2 minutes on 94.5 ESPN and on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee. Don't go anywhere. Ben Brust here to tell you about Zimbrick European. They're Mercedes, Audi, Porsche, and